Amen, amen, amen. What an empowering and sobering word from God. Oh my goodness. Hallelujah. Yes, we are in spiritual warfare. Oh my gracious. But we are equipped. Hallelujah. We are just going to meditate on this word because we have our covering pastor in the house today, and she is going to bring some beautiful additional nuggets to us. So let's meditate on this word right now. We are going to sing the song, Let the Church Say Amen, because A is the application of the word, M is the meditation of that word, E is the embracing of the word, and N is nailing that word into our heart in Jesus' name. So let's sing this song together, Let the Church Say Amen, and at the closing, our covering pastor, Dr. Maria Seaman, will bring the nuggets.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church,
say amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Let the church, say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church,
to what his words
say. The church say, oh,
oh, oh, oh, lift your hands wherever you are and let the church.
Amen. Praise God. At this time, we are going to invite our covering pastor, Dr. Maria A. Seaman, to do the nuggets. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you, Beacons for Christ Ministry. Boy, my heart is so full. It's amazing. I greet you, Pastor Randy Lightborn. I honor the Spirit of God in you. And I'm saying that specifically. I want you to remember I said that. I honor the Spirit of God in you. All right? That's very important as I go into my comments based upon the Word of God that you have ministered. Of course, I lift high the name of Jesus. Jesus is our Lord, our Savior, and our soon coming King. And so, therefore, as soldiers, of the cross of Calvary, where our Lord and Savior took the hit for all of humanity, we lift up the name of Jesus. We are thankful to God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, the triune Godhead, that we are covered in purpose. And so one thing I am just totally convinced of is that I don't have enough of this life to understand even the, I think, first 10% of the Bible. I just do declare, I just will not live long enough to understand the word and appreciate it in its totality. As much as I read, study, and think, which is continuously, read, study, think, and think, and think, I continue to hear God's word and say, wow, that the eyes of my insight are opened up even the more. I will say that I do also believe that this sermon is a good step with this morning's message from Superintendent, because it deals with sight. Who is blind and who sees? Beacons for Christ, I want you to listen as I share with you some things I've never seen before in God's word that I gleaned. And I tried not to write, I really do, because I know that once I start writing, it can be a book, trust you me. Did I say hi to Beacons for Christ? R.I.T. Laquita, R.I.T. Stacy. Amen. My best buddy there, Rev Eunice. You must be pretty special. That's all I gotta say. Yeah. How you doing, Josh? Good to see you, man. Good to see you right there. Good to see you. And all of you that are becoming so familiar. The next generation I see up in there. Larika, I'm missing your voice. I hope you're coming back soon. I want to hear that blessed voice. If she ain't getting by, I'll be dealing with her. Get it together. Because you're a blessing. And my brother there, I forget your name, but I see you. I want to talk about this sermon. Spiritual warfare. So for the last week or so, I'm walking around the house. I'm going, Maria, you got to get to National Geographic. Why? Now I'm talking back and forth. For you to understand, I know what I'm saying when I'm asking myself. I ain't crazy, but I'm letting you know. Why? Because God keeps showing me the lion behind the trees, crouched. And what's blowing my mind, because now you're going to enter my mind. What's blowing my mind, I'm saying, but this is the king of the jungle. I'm saying, this is not a small animal. This is a lion. You know, I've been to Africa, so I've seen some lions, not as many as I want to. So I got to get back to see more. And so I'm like, look, this lion. Huh? But that's his strategy, the way he goes to get the prey. So you never outright experience the lion until it's at you. Now, for those of us that are undergirded by the word of God, we're good, because that's where his gumlet is. Now, say add this to it, Seaman. Okay, I will. Now, to those who think that they're girded by the word of God, but they're really sissies and scaredy cats, you're not going to survive, because the roar is going to scare you. Okay, Seaman, why is it that the world is so loud? Because we've got a lot of scaredy cats, scared of the roar of the lion. Right. Now, as for the sinner being devoured, it don't matter that you hear them, they're loud and they're partying, rivalry, they have already been devoured. Now, they happen to be alive, so there is a day that they have for grace and mercy. But as sinners, they're already devoured, all right? And they happen to be light Right now, they like being the meal, so we're not going to convince them of anything. I'm saying to the Christian, he's as a roaring lion. Now, we don't want to minimize that. Because let me be true. Let's be true. Let me get Eunice on Isaiah. You could have said to me, like a slithering alligator. I don't know if she knows where I'm going. She don't know because she would have laughed louder. Listen, now she knows. Because when we went to Africa and we stood by the alligators, now they got a fence up, wall up. I'm got my camera, I'm going to take action. The alligator or what, a crocodile, I don't care what it was, comes out, she's like, pasta, pasta. Messing up my picture, messing up my moment, because she's trying to protect me, and it's got fences and. So let me go back to saying this. You see, the roar can cause a reaction. And we've got Christendom now where the roar is causing a reaction. And I'm very serious about that, all right? Let me hurry because I got, I'm not even apologizing. So you got this warfare is real. Warfare is serious, right? You got Satan's tactics, Jesus' remedy, right? Okay, got it. Now here's something big. Here's something big. We don't really understand, church, that we're in spiritual warfare. We understand it intellectually, but we don't understand it intimately. Talk to him, Seaman. All right. This is what God told me while I was listening to you. And it's perfect. I'm glad we're still in June. Did I say I'm glad we're still in June? Now listen to me here. Because again, God's speaking. Okay, all right, all right. Different dimensions. So Daniel prayed 21 days. Over in a dimension that we cannot see. Pay attention. But it exists. He said the prayer been answered, but it's spiritual warfare going on. So it's stuff that we're doing here on earth, unaware of, even as Christians. Nobody more Christian than Daniel, let's put it that way, because his life couldn't be marked. Remember that. His life couldn't be marked. And yet Daniel wasn't aware until literally angel told him, yeah man, we heard your answer and we was on our way. However, Holy Ghost, in a place, in a realm that you cannot see, there is warfare. Okay, Seaman, teach him something now. All right. This is where I'm glad I'm a scientist. Roy G. Biv, the visible rainbow. Let me take my time. We see, according to the visible rainbow. Take your time, Seaman. All that we do is based on what we see. Ain't no faith in that. No faith. The visible rainbow is not about faith. Come on, teach them. Oh, Lord. This is a sermon, Seaman. Teach them. All right. When God said, I'm putting my bow in the sky, he had to do that because it's not operating by faith under the old covenant. So he puts a literal, hallelujah, physical rainbow. That's your proof. Because there's going to come a time in 2023 when you're going to have to understand that since you are not people of sight, because sight will limit you to a physical rainbow. I need you to go higher and not operate by sight, but operate by faith. That means Christians, we cannot operate according merely to the physical rainbow. We've got to go beyond the dimension of the physical rainbow into, I'll say it like this just for our conversation scientifically, the ultra world, ultraviolets, okay? The colors that cannot be seen. Help me, Holy Ghost. The devil, now here we go with Genesis, with Luke, right? With the temptation. He always shows you the devil is a liar. And I rebuke the spirit of the devil is a liar. He will show you the rainbow. Yes, he will. He showed Eve. See it? He showed Jesus. See it? Hold your hats, folks, if you had a hat. Hold your, what's your? Jesus, the living word, the word himself, he gave back the word. Because the word, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. That's how they conquer. That's how you're going to conquer. So it can be based on the present rainbow of what I can see with these eyes, your eyes. They see according to the rainbow. And that's why the devil has put the rainbow out there, because it's captivated the eye. Come on, put it in children's clothing. Put it in children's bathing suits. Put it everywhere. All the rainbow colors. Why? Because the church has not told them, you got to go beyond the rainbow. You got to go into that dimension that cannot be limited by the colors of the rainbow. As a matter of fact, scientifically, if you put all the colors of the rainbow together, you get white light, one color. The distractions are in the colors. And so, thank you. Let's talk about it for a moment. Let's talk about it for a moment. On, what was that, Hero Day, whatever they want to call it these days, that day on Monday, that Bermuda had a holiday. What is the captivation of that day? If you don't get it, you're going to go in detention. Let me give you the answer so everybody stays out of detention. Colors. Oh, the colors. Oh, the lights. Oh, the colors. A physical manifestation of the rainbow. And I am saying that we lower who we are by focusing on the colors. We've got to go up into where the warfare is not the colors. I love the colors. I love them all. The warfare is in the unity of the colors, which means the warfare is beyond the colors themselves. The warfare is taking it up a notch and entering into spiritual warfare. Hence, I say, under the authority of the anointing of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, that the church, the real living church of God, has reclined and has drawn back from spiritual warfare. No, we want to be accepted. We want the alphabet people to like us. We want the alphabet people. We got to like them. Let me tell you something. For God so loved the world. Stop. Stop your horses right there. I'm going to take you somewhere now. I'm going to take you somewhere. For God so loved the world. Go back to Luke. Satan says, shows him in the instant. Shows him the world. Hold on. Hold on. Satan showed him the world at an instant. Men and women of God. Satan never showed him you. And Satan never showed him me. Hear me. Hear me. Satan showed him in a present moment the world. He never shared in Bermuda. You think Satan would have shared in Bermuda and Africa? Satan would have got saved. He only shared in present. Why? I'm not even looking at my notes because I feel the Holy Spirit. Why? Because Satan always wants to distract you with right now rather than what is to come. Now, here's what I got. Jesus being tempted. What would it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his own soul? If Jesus had said, yeah, give me the world, he would have lost his earthly soul as a human and every soul that was attached to the 12 disciples from history up to today. Your pastor, Randy, would have never had the opportunity to change from a soul type to a Paul type and to minister this word in excellence. Don't sell out your legacy through a now moment. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, and this is from Bermuda, everybody I'm speaking. Look, sex is never that good. Alcohol, never that good. Drugs, never that good. Weed, you know, cigarettes, lying, being hateful, all of them. They're never that good to give up the impact of what you cannot see. Here's a question I have. When was the last time one of the angels had a call on Michael for you? Woo! Hallelujah. Well, let me tell you, I'll go back and listen to that and I'll say, Maria, good thing you just know that God has you. Because people, perhaps in their right mind, would say some things you say. But then, that's all right, I ain't got my mind. I've got the mind of Christ. So I'm going to say it. But I'm telling you, you got to think about that. The rainbow, presently what we can see. Spiritual warfare occurs in realms, dimensions that we cannot see. So Christians, do we want to be impressed by what we see? Or do we want to say, God, blind me to this world and help me to know your world so that I can be in this world and not of this world? You said something about that too. Let me see if I'm going to get to it. I don't know if I am. Oh, so much mercy. Okay, let me say this. Listen to me here. When Satan said, I said, ooh-wee, enough of something. Satan said, don't forget, in Isaiah, right? I will. He said this, and for the first time in my life, I heard this. And Eunice and ETCM people will get it quicker. He said, I will exalt myself above the stars of God. Hold on. We've been thinking the literal stars. No. The stars of God are the pastors. The pastors. Hold on, Seaman. Hold on. That means Satan saying, I will get to a place where they will prefer me over a preacher. Hiya. Listen, I'm so full right now. I don't know if you want to hear from me or not. I'm just going to keep on going. Listen to me. We have gotten to the place where people, they'll be ripping at Pastor Seaman. And you, Pastor Randy, and Reverend Janice, all you peoples, right? By saying, oh, just let us. We want to be happy. Just have our way, you know, do all that. The crime is, watch this now, that those who should know the word and be able to present the word have been silenced. Well, I don't know about you. You just might thinking then, are we, those who have been silenced, are they really engaged in the spiritual warfare? See, spiritual warfare is not for me and you, you know, me against you. No. Daniel wasn't praying against Daniel. Daniel needed some help because the adversary was out for him. So this spiritual warfare is not Christian against Christian. That's why, look, I just get over things and move on. Some things take me for a loop a little bit more, but I get over these, I move on. The real warfare is who is after to devour the sinners. So the church has silenced herself, the stars. So if the stars are silenced, Satan is exalted. Folks, I'm going to say a big sentence because it just came to my ears. I don't know why God said it, but I'm going to say it. He just told me, and I just heard it right here, right here. He said, satanic worship happening in church. What? What are you talking about, God? He said, yeah, well, they're not lifting up my name above the rainbow into spiritual warfare. That means they are becoming stars unto themselves. Whoa. Oh. So if the sword isn't being used, if sweetness is being used, ooh, what are we doing? This is serious stuff, and I'm rushing on, believe it or not. I didn't even write a lot, but yeah. Want to know good and evil. That's Eve. Lust of the flesh, lust of the eye, pride of life. Can we just say today? So we went from the first Adam, not here. Going from the first Adam, literally, in the Garden of Eden, to the second Adam, our Jesus, in the Garden of Gethsemane, to Adam today. That's every male. Every male. You are Adam. What are you doing in your garden? Who are you covering in your garden? I looked at maybe three pictures. I said, you're telling me a husband don't mind his wife dressing like that? Or a father don't mind his daughter dressing like that? They ought to all be put in jail, far as I'm concerned. Put them in jail. But it's revelry. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Because it's like a fever. It's a fever. Which means the whole area becomes hellish. The same people, ask them to wear that to work. Now, this isn't right, and I wouldn't wear that work. Yeah, well, you're proud of it one a day. Wear it to work. Come as you are to work that way. Oh, different now, isn't it? And the same people that didn't mind watching it, they'd be like, you know you're supposed to write like that. You had that day. Oh. So the place does matter. And the dress does matter. Okay. All right, Seaman. Move on after that. And then Satan. Satan. I'm sucking my teeth again. Satan. Offering Jesus the kingdom. When it was Jesus and God and the Holy Spirit that gave him the kingdoms in the first place. Cast him out of heaven and said, you run that. You ain't running this, you run that. Run this. The devil always going to try to give you something he doesn't have authority over. And we've got to learn not to receive it by the word. That's the key. And superintendents say, you can't fight it if you don't have the word, you don't know it. And even if you don't have it totally memorized, there's an instinct. There is a warfare about the word of God. Like my mom, she knows all this scripture and stuff, right? Because she hid it in her heart. So in her youth, she got it. Now she can still pray and sing, and we do Psalms 27 together and Psalms 133. It's already made a train track in her, Lord Jesus, in her brain. If we're not even training them, where are we going to track them to? No, Satan's going to attract them. Serious things here. And so here's a thought I had. I'm not going to go into it. But the thought is that the devil wants to remove light and make churches dark, like clubs. And Bishop mentioned it just this afternoon while I was driving her. She said she ran out to preach somewhere. So it must have been this past week. And before she got up, the pastor said, turn up all the lights. We don't need this darkness. And she said, that's good, because she said, you know, I was about to deal with it. I said, I know you were too. Bishop doesn't like no darkness. Be careful of the darkness. Watch this. The darkness at night and the darkness of the day. He doesn't like light. This statement here, watch this. The Christian, you're more than light, you know. Ooh, say it this way, Seaman. The Christian, you're more than visible light. If you have faith, remember the rainbow, you are more than physical light. You're light at another dimension. So when you enter the room, even if you enter the room and they know your Holy Ghost filled and sanctified, they can't stand you in the room. Because you're light. Now, if those revelers and all are your friends, now they may be your relatives. You can't help who your relatives are. But if you're out there, your friends, and you drink and do whatever with them, I don't know what light you have. I don't know. See, it's a different. Jesus died for sin. Okay? And very powerful, Pastor Randy, that Satan wanted Jesus to skip the cross. Come on, somebody. That's a dancing moment right there. Where's Director Ryan? That's a dance. Hold on. I'm going to preach. Some of this stuff I'm going to preach. Help me, Lord, if you tarry. He wanted him to skip the cross. Now, watch this, church. The big question is, will you skip your cross? Will you say it's too much? It doesn't take all that. Yes, it does. Who you bluffing? Yes, it does. And in this day and age, it takes a whole lot more. All right? I'm almost done. Your point one had a whole pile of stuff. I stopped writing at point two. So, yeah. I said that. Yes. He never shared us. Wow. And then, yeah, let's end it here. John 17:17. Thy word is truth. Sanctify us through thy word. Here's the key. You know, we don't mind music. We don't mind clapping and singing. But when it comes to the word, if that's when you get sleepy and you fall, you ain't sanctified enough. Say it again, Seaman. Say it for clarity the second time around. Let me say it again. If you're wide awake for praise and worship, for all the hot music, good music, you're just a Christian raveler is all you are. Don't say that too loud, Seaman. Okay. If you're awake for all of that, and you're not coming straight from church like the Pastor Seaman, who once in a while gets sleepy, but always hears everything. But not today, though. I'm on point today. The word of God, you get sleepy. I can't even go sleep. Even if you see my eyes like this, I'm hearing everything, writing notes down. But not today, though. I'm doing good. If you find you're not attracted to the word of God, then it cannot be in you as a magnet. The magnetic attraction of the word of God that sensitizes you to there is something that is about to be spoken that will add to my life and cause me to stand in a time when so many are sinking. You're not sanctified enough. And I would advise you to get sanctified. How do you get sanctified? Recommit yourself to Jesus Christ. Fall in love with the word, Jesus, and then the written word, the Bible. And then you're going to find, you can't take the Bible and go down and revel. I'm pretty sure nobody was down there holding the word and saying, thus said the Lord. I'm talking about amongst the revelers, because you can do both. I'll end it by saying this again. Spiritual warfare, whether you like it or not, if you are a soldier, from a private, from the lowest rank, from a private upward, if you are truly in the army of the Lord, this is the day that you must be trained skillfully, because warfare has run amok. Warfare is not, everything I hear, I say, you know, listen to this. God just said, warfare, he said, Maria, just in a split second, he gives me sentences. He says, Maria, warfare has come from the dimensions now. It's just walking in. Just walking in. Just walking in. Why should I have to have warfare with a brother or a sister, a saint or a sinner? Because the enemy thinks he just can walk in. Because it's got more influence in the earth realm. Well, guess what? The word of God. That's why I'm going to succumb the word of God. Go into the word of God more and more. That's right. You come against me, I'm going into the word. I'm going to preach some more. That's what I'm going to do. I'm doing a live this week. Superintendent and I, we're doing a live. We're going to talk about this bacchanal spirit. This demonic spirit that thinks it can just show up with its visible self. Well, I know a God, and God will have the angel Michael, or if he need be, have the angel Gabriel, and he will make sure that we are well covered as we come against the Antichrist spirit. Beacons for Christ, I continue to say, you are blessed among many to have a man who is not like many. I read some of your comments during the sermon. Keep it up. Encourage your man of God. He needs it. It cannot be easy to stand apart. But that's what sanctification does. I love you, Beacons for Christ Ministry. You are, I feel now like the Apostle Paul, you are joy to my heart. And you add strength to my mortal being. God continue to bless you all and keep you. It's my prayer. Blessings abound.
Amen. My goodness. We have been rightly fed, haven't we? My God. We have been rightly fed. Thank you, Jesus. We received an anointed word, and we, oh my goodness. And then our covering pastor comes in and just literally enlightens us further. We are just so blessed. Can we not see just how much God loves us? Look who he has in our path. Hallelujah. We are so thankful and blessed. We invite our IT Stacy at this time to come and do the closing prayer. Amen.
Blessings, everyone. Blessings. Thank you, Pastor Seaman, for this wonderful nuggets. And as always, thank you, Pastor Randy. So powerful. The delivery, you know, the tactics, revealing those tactics and then the remedies. I just thank you. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Father God, we just pray today, O God, thanking you, O God, for your goodness and your mercy towards us, O God. Lord, I thank you for the man of God. Lord, I pray that you would replenish and restore him even now, O God. But as we have sat under this teaching of these two anointed pastors, O God, I pray in the name of Jesus that we would take to heart what is being said, O God, that we would learn how to apply these things, O God, not just have head knowledge, but Lord, let it indwell in our hearts, O God. Let the Spirit of God richly manifest it so that it pours out, O God. Father God, I pray in the name of Jesus that, Lord, as you have shown us some of the tactics of the devil, Father God, I pray that the remedy, O God, the one remedy, O God, that, Lord, I would hold on to is your word, O God. The psalmist said, your word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against you. And Lord, for us to call ourselves Christians, O God, and not hold on to your word, that is a sin, O God. When we don't look to your word for wisdom and understanding, that is a sin, O God. I thank you, O God, because Lord, you have, Lord, revealed this to me, O God. So Lord, I pray that as we go forth in this week, O God, that all of us would desire to be aligned with this word, that we would study to show ourselves approved, that we would look into this word, and that, Father God, it would definitely take root on good soil, O God. I pray, Father God, that our hearts will be conditioned to receive what you have said, Father God, through your manservant. I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We thank God for the closing prayer. We thank God for all aspects of our service today. Amen. As we glorified him from the opening song to the anointed word of God, the prayers in between, the scripture readings in between, the powerful message, the anointed nuggets that came after, and the closing prayer just now. It's just been an absolutely honorable service to our Lord and Savior, and we are so grateful. Let's go right into our declaration at this time. And let us speak it boldly from where we are. We are sons and daughters of the Most High God, being built into a mighty fortress because we love, adore, are loyal, and are passionate toward our King Jesus Christ, are prepared to do his business and walk into the supernatural power of his kingdom. Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. We speak that into the atmosphere, and we know that it falls on solid ground. It hits the ground with authority. Amen. Hallelujah. That spoken word, that affirmation. We thank you at this time for joining us. We are just so grateful. We want to thank our covering pastor, Dr. Maria A. Seaman, one more time for taking the time to join us today. It is always an extra blessing to have our mighty woman of God presence in the Zoom room with us as we honor the Lord God in this service. So we are grateful, and we just want to take the time to tell you thank you. Thank you for taking the time to join us, whether it's live here today or later on when you join via social media links. We appreciate you. We thank you for joining us. May God continue to richly bless you. We encourage you to shine bright and be a beacon of light. God bless you. Blessings abound.